Former Vice President Joe Biden comforting a Parkland family at an event weeks after the mass shooting.
I'm Chris Hickson's wife.
God love you.
Thank you. I wanted to.
Okay. This is Chris's son.
I'm his son.
Well, how are you? Thank you for hugging me.
Mm-hmm. You okay?
You okay? You'll be okay. We're gonna be okay. We're gonna be okay. Okay, I promise.
I'll be a better friend. A bigger person when life.
More than 42 years after he lost his wife and daughter in a car accident, Vice President Joe Biden is again wrestling with crippling grief. The Biden family, along with the President and First Lady and hundreds of others, filled St. Anthony of Padua Roman Catholic Church in Wilmington, Delaware today for the funeral of Beau Biden. The 46-year-old son of the Vice President died a week ago of brain cancer. The Vice President himself did not speak, but President Obama delivered a moving eulogy.
Beau Biden brought to his work a mighty heart. He brought to his family a mighty heart. What a good man. What an original. May God bless his memory and the lives of all he touched.
Easier to be a parent this morning. It's easier to be a dad, to tell your kids character matters.
It is now my great honor to introduce the President-elect of the United States of America, Joe Biden.
The people of this nation have spoken. They've delivered us a clear victory, a convincing victory, a victory. For we the people.
The grace and generosity that President Bush showed me and Laura Bush showed Michelle, and it was a reminder that we can have fierce disagreements and yet recognize each other's common humanity, and that as Americans we have more in common than what separates us.
I think if Americans would love their neighbor like they would like to be loved themselves, a lot of the division in our society would end.
That's what this means. It's a new beginning. And everybody needs to get off their high horse and reach out to their friends and neighbors and try to make it possible.
If, in fact, as George said, we're looking for what binds us together, the American people are strong, they're tough, they can get through hardship, and there's no problem they can't solve when we're working together. I think that was the theme of Joe's inaugural speech, and I think all of us discovered that we're at our best when we're all moving in the same direction.
America's a generous country with people with great hearts. All three of us are lucky to be the president of this country. Mr. President, I'm pulling for your success. Your success is our country's success, and God bless you.
I'm glad you're there, and I wish you well. You have spoken for us today. Now you will lead for us. And we're ready to march with you. Good luck. God bless you.
Joe, I'm proud of you. And you and Kamala need to know that you've got all of us here rooting for your success, keeping you in our prayers. And we will be available in any ways that we can as citizens to help you guide our country forward. We wish you Godspeed.
Thank you for your example and how to remain the same good guy that you were when you first got here. Most of all, for your friendship. My life and the lives of many have been enriched by it.